Hello, here we discuss about the combinational logic. Okay, now first of all, what is combinational logic? So the combinational logic where the circuit consists of logic gates. So the circuit consists of logic gates where set of inputs are there and set of outputs are there. Okay, now if n number of attributes are there, so total number of possible inputs would be 2 to the power n, but for each set of input there is a fixed output. This particular portion is important. So for each set of input, fixed number of outputs are there. So we will be seeing that what is how to construct combinational logic. Here we should know the basic, the steps are, first of all we should know the truth table, we should know the Boolean function, and we should know the logic diagram. So in this case we will see the first combination circuit. Half adder and full adder. So truth table of half adder, say two inputs are there, x and y, and two outputs are there, c and s. So the set of inputs and set of output. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And if 0, 0 addition summation is 0, carry 0, 0, 1 sum is 1, carry 1, 1, 0 sum should be 1, carry 1, 1 plus 1 sum should be 0 and carry 1. Clear? So first then that means we have to identify the Boolean function, okay, using the map method, using kmap method. So two inputs are there. Okay, so for C we have to develop a map, and for S we have to develop another map. So if for C, if x and y 1 1, then it is 1 and z should be 0. That means what is C? C should be what? Sorry, it should be y. So C should be what? X and y. And x, if x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1, then it should be 1. If x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, then it is 1, and rest should be 0. Then what is s? S is equal to what? X dash y for this, and for this it is x and y dash. So this is nothing but x xor y. Okay, so we can easily construct the so x and y, so the AND gets. This is what, x and y, and for s it is like this, x dash and y and get, similarly x and complemented y, okay, and we have to add these two. So this is nothing but our XOR circuit, or we can draw like this way. This is for X and this is for Y. This is nothing but XY, or it is C, and this is for X. Okay, so this is what half adder circuit. Similarly, we can construct the full adder circuit also. So the input set are like this. So two variables are there, C and S. These are the input, and two outputs are there. So 0 plus 0 plus 0, sum is 0, carry 0. 0 plus 0 plus 1, sum is 1, carry 0. 0 plus 1 plus 0, sum 0, carry sum 1 carry 1, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, okay, 1 0 0 sum 1 carry 0, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, 1 1 0 sum 0 carry 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1 sum 1 carry 1. Now we have to construct KMF for C. So x dash x, y dash z dash, y dash z, y z and y z dash. C. And for S, okay, now see if it is 0 1 1, if it is 0 1 1 then it is 1, then it is 1 0 1, so if it is 0 1, so 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0, and for 1 0 1, 1 0 1 it is 1, 1 1 0 1 1 0 it is 1 and 111, okay. So we have to form group like this one, this one and this one, so three groups are there. So for that, for this particular group it is YZ, for this group it is X and Z, and for this it is X and Y. Okay, now this is what, this is nothing but our carry. So this is nothing but our carry. Similarly for sum, for sum 0 0 1, so 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0. So if it is 0 0 1, 0 0 1 it is 1, 0 1 0 0 1 0 it is 1, 1 0 0 1 0 0 it is 1, okay, and 111 it is 1. So sum will be x dash y dash z plus x dash y z dash, x y dash z and x y z. So we can simplify further. So if you take x dash common, if you take x dash common from both, so y dash z plus y z dash, here if you take x common, y z is y dash z dash, sorry, so it is y z. So this will be what, x dash y xor z, and it is x y xnor z. Now once again apply the formula, XOR formula, so X XOR Y XOR Z, okay. Now easily you can draw the figure for sum. So three inputs are there, X Y and Z. So for sum it is Y Z complement first, so it is like this. And width, okay, so this is for sum, and for, because sorry, it should be z here, so it is a y xor z, and from this it is x y xor z. Now similarly for the carry, x into y, x into z, and y into z. This is what carry. So half subtractor, okay. So x and y, b and d. So we can, we want to draw the half subtractor. So 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. So 0 minus 0, borrowed 0, difference 0, 0 minus 1. So if you 0 minus 1, you have to borrow 1 data, and 1 0 minus 1 it is 1, 1 minus 0 the difference is 1, the borrow is 0, 1 minus 1. Difference is 0, borrow 0. So there should be two KMF, one for B, 1 for D, x dash x, y dash y, x dash x, y dash y, okay. 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. If it is 0 1, then it is 1, rest would be 0, so B is equal to what? It is x dash y. Similarly, what about the D? So if 0 1 0 1 it is 1, if it is 1 0 then it is 1, ratio should be, so D is equal to what? X dash y plus x y dash, so that means what? X x or y. So we can easily, you can draw the figure for logic diagram for B and D. So two inputs are then x and y, so complement of x with y, we have to AND it. This is nothing but our B. Similarly, x xor y, this is our difference. We can construct the full subtractor also. So x y and z, so two outputs are there, borrow and difference. Very interesting outputs are there. So 0 minus 0 minus 0, difference is 0, borrow 0. 0 minus 0, it is 0. 0 minus 1, so 0, 0 minus 1. So to subtract it, we have to borrow one thing, one data. And if we borrow one thing, now it is 1, 0. So 1, 0 means what? It is 2, 2 minus 1, it is 1. So it is in binary, it is in binary, it is in decimal. So it is, the difference is 1. 0 minus 1, the borrow is what? Borrow is 1, we have to borrow this one. So 1 0 minus 1, 1 0 minus 1, it is 1. And similarly, 1 0 minus 1, it is 1. 1 minus 0, it is 1. Similarly, 0 minus 1, borrow is 1. 1 0 minus 1, it is 1. 1 0 minus, it is 1. 1 minus 1, the difference is 0. 1 minus 0, no borrow, difference is 0. 1 minus 0, okay. So the borrow is 0, difference is 1. Similarly, 1 minus 0, it is 1, no borrow. 1 minus 1, 1 minus 0, it is 1. 1 minus 1, it is 0. 1 minus 1, no borrow, 0. 1 minus 1, it is 0. 0 minus 0, it is 0. 1 minus 1, it is 0. 0 minus 1, we have to borrow one thing, and 1 minus 1, it is 1. Okay, so 0, triple 1, 1, and 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. And easily we can draw map method. So using map method, we can identify the logic, so the boolean function, boolean expression. So x dash y, y dash z dash, y z is y z and y z dash, 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 1. Okay, so when it is 1, 0 0 1, 0 0 1, it is 0 1 0, 0 1 0, it is 1, 0 1 1, 0 1 1, it is 1. Okay, triple 1, triple 1, it is 1. X dash z, x dash y, and for it is y z. This is for borrow, and for difference, so 0 0 1 0 0 1 it is 1, 0 1 0 0 1 0 it is 1, 1 0 0 1 0 0 it is 1, triple 1 triple 1 it is 1. So difference is nothing but our x dash y dash z, x dash y dash z, then x dash y z dash, x y z z, and x y z. So it is same as this one, it is same as this one, same as this one. So the output will be nothing, x, x or y, x or z. And easily you can draw the circuit. So three inputs are there, x, y and z. So for borrow, x dash z, so x dash z. Next x dash y, x dash y. Next y z. We have to all it. Similarly, for d, x dash y x y, so and y z. So for this one, then okay. So this is for difference, and this is for borrow. Okay, so it will be y z, and this is x. So x x or y x or z. And this is the end of this video. Thank you very much.